My name is Noah, and I'm going to tell you about a universe vastly different from ours. A calm and peaceful universe. A universe where forgotten characters go to experience peace. This is known as the Hub Universe. Now, you're probably wondering, how do I know about this? Well, I'm going to tell you. It all started at my job. I work as a cashier at an arts and animation store. It was a pretty normal day until something weird started to happen. I started seeing things. There was shuffles through the shelves, and lights coming from the products. So I decided to look into it, and I found one of the craziest things I've ever seen in my life. A Hub Universe on my desktop computer where forgotten characters go to be at peace. This was all so interesting to me, and that's why I'm devoted to figure out everything about this and understand the Hub Universe.
Watch out, world is Metal Man!
Oh, hey! It's me, Metal Man. Everyone's favorite superhero who's metal all the time. I'm about to go on a long journey, leaving all the flying cars, floating islands, and neon lights behind. Ah, the life of a recognized character. But hey, at least it's for a good cause. I'm about to set off on a long journey to rescue all of the unknown characters from the Hub Universe, where they remain hidden from the rest of the world. Like Mackie Mouse. Bet you didn't know who that is. You know, Walt Disney, who made him? Bet you don't know who that is either. And even some old apps like Snapchat and Vine. They're all there, and I'm going to get them out.
So, how long have you been in the Hub Universe?
Well, the year was 2012. My creator, Walt Disney, brought me to this universe, The king and queen greeted me and introduced me, Jealous of their power, I slipped some painful liquid into their drink, and I became king. So one day, Vine tried to overthrow me. She was like, "What's up?" And I was like, "What's up?" And then my guards threw her out. You know the rest. Now, all I got is Mixar, 23rd Century Fox, Space Fight, Jarvel, and the Hobbits.
So I want to go over to the real world and take it over. Try a hot dog, a dog, a tickety dog.
brought into the Hub universe, and so declared its protector of sorts. Sure, it gets tiring sometimes, especially since we've been here since... I don't even know how long. Is it still the 1950s? I've lost track of time. Over the years, as more characters have come into this Hub universe of ours, I've found that the environment is happier and less lonely. It's nice not to be lonely. But needless to say, some of the characters still get on my nerves. Fine.
How did you gain so much power in the Hub universe?
Well, as you can see, I'm fine. I came in a bit later than everyone else. Everyone was like, who are you? And I'm like, Atlas famous and you will not. So you gotta respect me! And guess what? They did! So yeah, now I'm basically the best person in the Hub universe, and also the sassiest. I kept on gaining power whenever someone new came in. They automatically respected me. I don't know why Mackie Mouse is a leader. It should obviously be me.
Why did you create the Hub universe?
It's always been a passion of ours to create things together. We did this for fun. I drew the animations.
And I wrote the scripts.
We were at first just doing this as a hobby, but we never could have anticipated how connected we would be to each of our creations. So, when they unfortunately never made it in the industry, we couldn't bear the thought of getting rid of them.
So we wanted to create a space for them, so we hired a programmer to create the file. They called it the Hub Universe, I guess.
We wanted to give the forgotten characters a chance to live on.
How have you been handling your time in the Hub universe?
Hi, it's Clippy here, and how I've been spending my time in the Hub universe is basically just by, you know, talking to the other rejected Microsoft artificial intelligence thing there. An action figure myself. It gets kind of lonely. Vine is telling everyone what to do. I don't want to leave my house. My house has, like, Windows XP processor walls on it, and it has a hill background. It was amazing. But sometimes, when I do leave my house, I like to have some fresh, good old computer chips with a topping of shredded Mac PC processor. I can't wait to find my place again, and you should go follow my Instagram, Clippy_official. Thank you.
Do you feel you fit in with the rest of the characters in the Hub universe?
Yes, of course. This place is great. I love that we have to get along with each other before we, explode with each other. It's great being the only Martian here. These people love me, but how could they not? Not everybody could pull up these snakes for hair. That Medusa girl tried, but I did better. Why would anyone want to leave this place?
Hey! It's me! Metalman! I've survived so many challenges since I last checked in. First, I needed to pass the River Styx. Then, I had to go through the Mackie Mouse Clubhouse. And then, of course, go on a few rides at Walt Disneyland. You know, the classics like Pirates of the Pacific Ocean, the Carousel of Old Progress. I'm sure that sitting on a roller coaster will help me learn to fly. It's science. Now, I'm about to enter the most dangerous part of my mission as I start to make the long journey across the desert to jump through the Hub universe and into the file where all of the forgotten characters are located. It will be difficult, but I must remember that I am doing this because I believe everyone deserves to be remembered.
What does the Hub universe mean to you?
I've created the Hub Universe, I spent countless hours sitting at my computer, typing line after line of code. Now, my magnum opus in the technological advancement of alternate digital realities has been completed. We've tested it, and it works. Now, rejected cartoon characters have a place to go where they're safe from people who want to get rid of them, especially people like the man I used to and now regret ever working with. But now, all that's left is to fulfill my destiny.
And what is that?
To go in to the Hub Universe and become a cartoon character, man's ultimate form.
Oh, okay.
I don't know much. This man, his name is Incognito. He's trying to.
We interrupt our program to bring you this.
The Hub is a threat to all of us. Why? Because when a cyber world like this pops up, a conflict arises. It may seem like a simple petty problem, but it escalates. When a character from the Hub world goes into the real world, things go downhill fast. History will never stay the same. Poof. Disappear. Your favorite memories gone. Your childhood gone. Living in peace gone. You may ask, who am I? Who am I? That's a good question. Remember me? I used to work on this together with you. We used to be close. We used to be friends. But I knew it. I knew it would have gotten out of hand. I knew it wouldn't be a simple little project, you said. Now look where it is now. This is your final one. If you don't shut it down, I'll have to do it myself. Incognito out.
If you could live anywhere in the universe, where would it be?
Right here, silly. We love it here. We? You mean you love it here?
Yeah, of course I do. This Hub Universe has been my home for as long as I can remember. I'm sure you haven't heard of me, right? The name's Lily Mouse. I never really made it in the real world, but here in the Hub Universe, I'm the star. And I have a purpose, so I don't really want to be anywhere else.
Hey, Gingy's big brother Robbie here. I mean, I'm just your average cookie. Yeah, my sister's really the one you know. Once I was created, there was this big gust of wind, and I ended up here. I would have escaped as soon as I could, but then I met Lily Mouse. I mean, she's kind of making things more complicated for me, as I would leave her any chance I could get, but I'm really not sure if I'm ready to leave her.
We'll figure it out. Don't worry, it's not like someone is gonna jump in here and try to save us. We got plenty of time to think about what to do.
Do you like your life in the Hub Universe?
I wanted so much more than I had when I was a bad guy. I didn't know that there were other things in the world. When Walt Disney booted me, I got a look at his workspace, and I saw the Waffle Tower, the Leaning Tower of Pizza, and I knew that my dream was to become somebody on the Food Network, like Remy from Ratatouille. And then I was booted here, and it crushed my dream. I just wish I could escape from it all and go to Mexico, because I love tacos. But I guess we'll just wait and see what happens.
was at a lot of research at Walt Disneyland, but I can fly now, so that's cool. Now I'm starting my long journey in the desert. I feel like I'm melting. Oh wait, I am. It's hard to be made of metal in the desert, but the good news is that I'm bulletproof. So even if I become liquid, I can still survive the journey. But wait, Mackie Mouse can try and stop me, but he will not succeed. Whoa, I see the vortex. There it is. It's time to test if I can fly. Here we go. Watch out, because I'm better than Peter Pan. I'm Metal Man.
Watch out, world, is Metal Man.
What is this? Aha! I knew it all along. I was wondering if there's other people trying to enter the universe. I figured I wasn't the only one who figured out about this, nor was trying to look into it. But this is also very, very intriguing. But I need to figure out more from the creators.
There's no way we could have known that this would happen.
But we are proud that this has become a safe space for these forgotten, unknown, lost souls.
We really just want what's best for them. We want what they want.
We'll keep the space open if they need it, as long as they need it. But if they are done with their time in the hub, they are free to go. It's their choice to make.
There's a security breach. The portal, it's open.
What are you talking about? What portal?
It's the vortex between the hub universe and the outside world.
Now's our chance. Let's go.
The entire hub is a threat, and it needs to go.
No, we don't delete it.
The hub universe is our home.
We've been here all of our lives. You can't just take this away from us now.
Even though my app doesn't exist, my videos live on in cyberspace. If you delete the hub, then I will be gone. What will my followers do? How will they watch the man almost drop his croissant?
Go ahead. Delete us. I mean, we're already forgotten.
We all still want to exist somehow.
You don't know the consequences that could come to this. Okay, I'm outnumbered. I won't delete the hub now. But I'll be back.
Together. Choose your own adventure. Find your hidden treasure. We all have our own dreams. It's time to pursue.
This week, during the Character Crash Course breakout session, the students and staff explored the exciting world of characters. Using the four F's of character development, family, function, flaw, and feature, the students created their own complex characters and took part in a high-stakes whodunit game. The object of the game? To find out who stole the precious diamond necklace from the museum gala. The suspects came from far and wide, from a Puffin actor to Peppa Pig, Olaf the Snowman to a southern grandma, the FBI director and English royalty, a taco-eating armadillo and Tony Stark, and finally, the comic relief who is afraid of squirrels and the long-lost app, Vine. Using their powerful deduction skills, in the end it was Olaf and Vine who discovered that Gerald the Puffin had indeed taken the necklace. "I couldn't have done it without them," said Inspector Mustachio. "Thanks for all your help cracking the case. Until next time, characters."
Dear women who write,
I am always loaning myself to others and need 9 hours of sleep every night.
Strong and unmuted.
A silly and creative person who hides behind herself.
Not the person I want to be.
An Afro-Latina woman.
A fairy godmother, a good listener, and a friend to all.
Resilient and determined.
A confident, independent woman.
A dreamer and a creator.
Powerful and strong-minded.
Strong and determined.
Outspoken and kind.
Strong and confident.
I wonder how everyone else can hear their internal monologue.
If everyone got the instruction manual except for me.
I hear music even in silence.
What the future holds.
A bright future that I'm not sure is mine.
The girl I am reaching for in the mirror. But I don't know how to reach her. She is worlds away.
I want progress with reflection.
I am always loaning myself to others and need 9 hours of sleep every night.
Strong and unmuted.
A silly and creative person who hides behind herself.
Not the person I want to be.
An Afro-Latina woman.
A fairy godmother, a good listener, and a friend to all.
Resilient and determined.
Confident, independent woman.
A dreamer and a creator.
Powerful and strong-minded.
Strong and determined.
Outspoken and kind.
Strong and confident.
I want theater to be inclusive of all body types, not just skinny, pretty ones.
I want fairness for all actors. Many people believe that lead roles are the most important, but each actor puts in an equal amount of hard work.
I want theater to be more inclusive. If we stop stereotyping certain races for certain roles, then theater will have more diversity.
I want to improve on the role of the directors in our theater community, so that more people have the opportunity to be what they want to be, no matter the gender or the race. Also, I want to take more recognition of the crew because they are usually underestimated and they are the foundation for the show.
I want more people to have the opportunity to watch theater. No matter how much money a person has, they should still have the opportunity to watch and enjoy theater just like many of us do.
I want theater to include actors as part of the creators. Therefore, they will have more say in the production.
I want to see more original stories in theater. It's become too common now to use historical events, movies, or the life of an individual, such as a singer, as the base of a plot. By doing so, writers feel inclined to stick to the facts and use actors that look just as the real people do or did. Brand new stories would allow for the representation and messages that we really should be hearing and seeing on stage today to be focused on.
I got a wheelbarrow full of cobblestone. I'm gonna lay the path of calm.
The dog woke up and went to the cat. But the cat said, I'm too pretty for you. Goodbye.
The dinosaur drank the red lake of Jadenville. He also went to Google's house with Siri.
Two sentences? Okay, I'm done.
It was raining earlier. Now it is thundering outside.
There was two aliens on the planet Mars doing normal alien things when they heard a rumble. It was an astronaut from SpaceX.
He said, yeah! I'm a ball of stinky hair! I make stink balls, hay balls, stress balls, and bouncy balls that make me stress.
And then he started crying because he had purple instructions.
The dough soap tastes better than the chocolate. Actually, the bird tastes the best.
Lydia went to store and asked her, what do you need?
There was a ticket. One thing everyone wants is to get. The one thing everyone wanted to do was eat in the 76 gymnast. The end.
Yay!
I got a locket with my lover inside. Now when trouble comes, I let it slide.
I took piano lessons for 3 years.
I do chorus, so I have a pretty good understanding of like a lot of music theory stuff.
So I know very basic stuff, don't know how to read music. I can just pick up pitch really well, like by ear.
So I kind of have like a good idea about music theory, but I would really love to learn more.
I've been playing guitar for 8 years, and that's my primary instrument.
So I play piano for funsies.
I took lessons like my whole life.
But I know like the basics, like I know how to read like the basic music. I just don't know how to read like the fancy stuff and all that.
The actual definition in the dictionary of music theory is the study of the practices and possibilities of music. There are kind of three main components to this concept of music theory, right? So we have melody, we have harmony, and we have rhythm. Create a story through things other than lyrics, right? So we're going to create a story through musical material, through chords and notes, okay? And do you hear how that feels like it wants to go back home? Can everyone hear that kind of, it's called a harmonic pull. G7, which is the 5, back to 1. And then you kind of have that in your ear. Right? To create a very simple lead sheet or chart for a song that you are writing or many songs that you are writing. Everyone can be looking at the same exact piece of paper with different instruments, and they're all understanding what this means. So if this is your first measure, you have your slashes, you have your chord, you have your tempo, and you have your dynamics underneath the staff. We have the subito piano, we have the crescendo through these eighth notes, and we're landing on 4 at forte. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. And then we have slash notation of the rhythms. So that's 1, 2, and 3, and 4. And bridges typically introduce something new, whether it's a new key area, it could be just new chords that you haven't explored yet in the verse and the chorus. It can be a change of feel.
Drag my feet on the floor. When someone calls, oh, there's always work left to do.
I want negative energy. If you get what you give, give me positivity.
Give it to me. Hey, be different. Be nice. Just smile. I promise it'll change your life. Be nice, just smile. I promise it'll change your life.
Be nice, be nice, be nice, be nice. The love you give is the love you get, so be nice and change your life.
Ooh, with a handful of plans in an empty room. There's a cool breeze once you rest the heavy load.
Act 3, The Fog at Thunder Road. A booming voice calls out, "Racers, to your vehicles!" You hop into your ride, you turn the key, and you rev the engine. You hear screams over the roars of the engines. The heart of whatever is in the fog has started to approach the cluster of vehicles that make up your team. I will be rolling on the table to determine what is in the heart of the fog. You as a team will have to combine together to defeat this thing of evil. Let's see what we roll.
Got a potato.
I think we gotta take some screws out of the tires on our unicycles and throw it at it and try to stab it so that it will stop moving.
You think screws are gonna stop me? Try hard.
My idea was to open back up that time warp and suck the blob back in, but now we got a different problem. We have Diana stuck in there.
All right, listen, that is a great way to get rid of the blob, but how are we gonna get Diana out of there? Listen, go for it.
I got Scooter's cousin Pepe. Scooter's-
we need you to get in there. We need you to save Diana Mite. You're the only person who can get in the blob. Everybody else, work on the riff. Pepe, tell us how you get Diana out of the blob.
I think we should chase it.
The blob is resisting. Its mighty cry roars out across the highway. And Diana is free. Oh man, there's gunk everywhere. It has gone through the rift. We have saved the day, everybody. Give yourselves a round of applause.
On to the next rocky road. And there's no wind like the table. No, I used to bang down doors.
Good morning, Mendez, USA. I'm Digit.
I'm Mute.
And I'm Stella.
And we're reporting live from home on Good Morning Mendez.
So, what do we have on the news today?
Well, Stella, the weather today is awesome. Clear skies and beautiful weather.
Let's welcome Miss Money, the CEO of Money Mobiles.
Hi, thanks for having me. I'm excited to announce that our self-driving cars now have the option of drone delivery to your home. A contactless way to get yourself a self-driving car.
Are you sure drones are the most effective way of delivery?
No need to worry. We use the finest and most efficient drones you can find. The drones can hold up to 10 tons, which is equivalent to 2 ambulances.
That is very interesting. Thanks for updating us here on Good Morning Mendez. Now back to Mute with some information on the HNP53 virus.
The death count of yesterday reached an all-time high. Doctors are still trying to find a cure for HNP53. There have been over 30,000 people with this virus, and over 50,000 people have been tested. Joining us now is our mayor, Fanny Fern, to talk more about this issue.
Attention, citizens of the town of Mendez, it's Fanny Fern here to discuss the HNP53 virus. Attention, citizens, I have important news to share. I have found a time capsule from the year 2020. That's over 150 years ago. The time capsule has important artifacts that will possibly help find the cure for HNP53. If anyone has any old photos, letters, journals, or anything from this year, please tune in to our town hall meeting tomorrow at 5 p.m. where we will all discuss this time capsule and what it means to our town.
Wait, what was that? That wasn't part of the broadcast.
Servers were hacked by the mayor's office. We need to put a stop to this.
Wait, we're still in the air.
All right, folks. That was just a funny April Fool's joke from the mayor.
It's June 21st.
Cut the feed!
Did you hear that, Grammy? The mayor just announced that she found a time capsule from the year 2020.
That's very interesting, honey, but can I go back to my crossword puzzle?
No, Grammy, I'm serious. The mayor just announced it on morning TV. She wants us to go search our homes for any memorabilia from 2020 and then meet her at the town square.
Well, if you are looking for something from 2020, my parents' old wedding photo is on the mantle. Maybe you can bring it to the town Zoom meeting.
Dear my beloved one, I've been thinking about you. We may be worlds apart, but our heart beats as two. If you find this letter, you will understand that the world is bright because it's in your hand. We will find our way just like we always do. The future lies in you. Grammy, who wrote this letter?
I didn't know about a letter on the back of that photo until now.
Whoever wrote it never got to finish their thought, because half the letter is missing.
Show the mayor what this letter says, and maybe you'll find the other half. Maybe there's something in this time capsule that could show us what to do. Maybe this photo is more than just a stained piece of paper.
Hello, friends. I hope you are having a
act together on the top, but check out these bad boys. But what if I told you that there was a way to shake up the look of it? Today I'm going to be doing something I'd like to call quarantine couture. To kick things off, I am so excited to be sharing a brand new product with you. This video is sponsored by Squeaky Clean, the newest line of disinfectant sprays that is versatile enough to be used on any surface, including the human skin. I've been using Squeaky Clean's products to wipe off all of the delivered packages that I've received with some of the accessories that I'll be featuring later on in this video. The spray keeps my packages clean from all the germs that could be found on other humans' hands. So before I get into showing you how to accessorize your sweatpants, let's wipe off some of these packages that just arrived with some of Squeaky Clean's products. Smells so good. Click the link below to find out where you can purchase Squeaky Clean so you don't have to worry about bacteria on your boxes. Now let's get into the video.
When people think of 2020, I want them to remember these words.
What? Sure, I guess. What's it for?
Okay. Is this okay? Might go back out tomorrow. Oh. Want to meet at the same Macy's as last time?
I'm confused. Huh? What does that mean? That doesn't make any sense. Why would you choose that? But I've always known you as a boy. There are studies about this? And you've read them? Oh. I still don't really get it. Of course I will.
Years from now, I want people to remember that 2020 was a time of aggressive snacking. Weekly fitness crazes, dozens of DIY projects, self-discovery, reimagining the meaning of home. Prior to spending 3 months straight in my own house,
All I ever wanted was to be there. Sometimes, having to leave it felt like an inconvenience. And while it's maintained its role as a shelter from the storm, if you will, recently it's felt like less of a reward to be within my own walls. I think I finally understand that your house is not always where you feel most at home. I want the future to remember a time when we couldn't choose to go home, wherever that might be. We were forced into our houses and away from the people or places that we loved. I hope no one will ever again take for granted being able to go out and explore the world, even in small doses. I know I won't.
Hey, how have you been?
Hey, I've been pretty okay.
It's crazy how everything is shutting down.
I know, my parents' store just had to close.
Ugh, that sucks. I'm so sorry. Hopefully this thing doesn't last too long.
It looks like things might be closed for a while, but we'll figure it out. I gotta stock up on squeaky clean products.
Oh, that reminds me. Did you see Chris Cayley's new video?
No, what was it?
It was super cool. She's like doing this accountability challenge thing where you can record your experiences throughout quarantine. It seems kind of fun. We should do it.
I mean, sure. Why not? There's nothing better to do.
That's true. You want to start tomorrow?
Okay. Let's check in in like a month, maybe?
That sounds good.
Okay. All right. Bye.
Bye.
So today was our first day inside, and to be honest, it was pretty interesting. I know I'm gonna miss school and my friends a lot, but there's gonna be a lot of time to stay busy, and so hopefully I can use all of this free time productively.
Day one of living this quarantine-age dream. See what I did there. But really, in all seriousness, I'm going to use this time to better myself. You won't even recognize me when all of this is over and done with, which is hopefully soon. Bye. Day number three. Surprise, still quarantine. So I started this new fitness plan and it's kind of okay so far. I'll let you know how that goes.
So it's been 1 week inside and I feel like I have an infinite number of things to do. In a way, being stuck at home makes me busier because everything is like right here asking to be done and I can't avoid it. It's no longer safe to go out, go to restaurants, stores, or even like friends' houses. So we've all been getting pretty creative. There's so much hope that this is going to be over soon, but regardless, this is a pretty big deal.
We are currently 1 week into this mess, and this morning I made the amazing decision to sit alone in my room for 2 hours scrolling through Instagram. I mean, it's so unfair. Why can't I look like these people? You know what, never mind. That's so not important right now. So, yeah. So it's day 13 and I barely got myself out of bed this morning to even work out, which is so odd for me, but.
So it's been a while since I last recorded, but I've been keeping track of a lot of the things that we've been doing to stay busy. So Zoom is huge right now. So Zooming with classmates, family, friends, even family I didn't know existed, which is kind of crazy. So there's that. There's also a lot of people have been exercising, which is something really fun also. There are so many exercise videos and exercise challenges, dance classes, even gymnastics practices online, which is like blowing my mind. It's crazy. There's also a huge baking trend going on right now, so much so that it's really hard to find flour and yeast and all that other baking stuff. But so far, I've made cinnamon rolls, I made pizza, cupcakes, bread, pies, cookies, brownies, and a whole bunch of other stuff. So yeah, that's been really fun. That's pretty much all that's been going on right now, and I guess I'll update you guys soon. Bye!
It is now day 22 in quarantine, and today I just took a good hard look at myself in the mirror, and I hated what I saw. Just gonna be honest. It's fine.
So it's been about a week since I last recorded, and I've been trying to stay active and productive, but it's crazy because I haven't seen anyone other than my family in a really long time. It's honestly really frustrating, but I'm just trying to stay positive.
It's now day 26, and this time alone with just myself and my thoughts has been the absolute worst thing for me. Yeah.
Hello? Hello? Are you there? Hello?
Do I hear something? Oh, hi.
You invited me. Do you need something?
Not really. Pocket Zoom, I guess. But we've been meaning to talk anyway, so happy accident.
Well, if you don't need me, I have to go, so.
No, you don't. Let's catch up on the challenge.
Okay, fine. It's been good.
Okay. Mine's been good too. I've been baking, exercising, sleeping, Netflixing, I did my parents' taxes, and I watched all the Jaws and Sharknado movies twice.
All right, I get it. You did all this. Do you really think that this is what this is about? This isn't about just bragging to each other. Would you ever even think to ask me about how I might be feeling?
Okay, how are you feeling?
Never mind. It's not important. Have fun with your whatever.
So some of the other fun things that I've been doing have been cleaning, and I've had a lot of time to like watch shows and movies, so that's pretty nice.
It's day 35, and I've decided that I am done feeling this way.
So I'm actually in the car right now because sometimes that's the only quiet and calm place you can go. So I'm super happy that I can do this and just chill or listen to music. I also really like dancing to music, so all those things have been fun.
So it's quarantine day 39 and I've tried to be really productive today, so I feel okay about that. It's all about the baby steps.
So I got to take a nap today, which is kind of crazy because I haven't had to wake up early in like 2 months. That's really fun.
It is now day 43 and I just have to know progress takes time, and what a coincidence, time is literally the only thing I have right now.
So something really important during this time has been masks, so I'm gonna show you my mask collection because why not. So first we have a bunch of these like disposable orange ones, and then there's these white ones. And then these black and white ones, these are my favorite because they're like super cool. And then these blue ones. So, yeah.
So it's now day 45 and this is my daily reminder to myself that I have got this.
So honestly, not much has been going on recently. Kind of just chilling and relaxing.
So it is now day 50 and I got a lot of sleep last night and now I'm ready to go out and get started with my day.
A lot of people have been going out and acting like this whole thing is over, but it really isn't yet.
It's now day 56, and today honestly has not been the best day, but I'm going to keep my head up because I know that tomorrow is a brand new day and it will be amazing.
This has honestly been really hard. I wish everything could go back to normal, but it seems like we're going to be like this for a while. So, we can do it though. Maybe.
Hey.
Hey.
So, how have you been?
I've been fine.
I've known you forever. Fine never means fine.
This time it does.
Okay, well, just a reminder, it's the last day of Chris Cayley's challenge, and I thought we were supposed to check in or whatever.
Yeah, we are. And I'm sorry that I wasn't there for you before. We were supposed to be there for each other, and I totally dropped the ball on that.
That would be an understatement.
I know. The closest I could get to being okay was people thinking I was okay. But the only person I couldn't convince was myself.
I was there for you. You could have talked to me.
I didn't really know how.
We were supposed to do this together, but doing it on my own still taught me something. I still came out stronger on the other side.
I don't think I know how to get through this on my own like you did.
You don't have to. I'm here to help.
Thank you.
And who needs a stupid challenge anyway? We have each other.
Yeah, you are so right.
Okay, let's start with your daily reminder. You are amazing and you could do anything you put your mind to. Now, let's go out there and crush this quarantine.
This moment, all that I need to be. This has always been my personal favorite Lowell affirmation, but I feel like during times like these, a whole new meaning is brought to the table. Throughout 2020, I lived with this constant struggle of thinking about what I should be doing more. I felt this fear of not being enough, of not doing everything that I possibly could to help myself and those around me, almost like I was letting everyone down. But by repeating this affirmation to myself over and over again, I realized that what I'm doing will always be enough, and that I am enough. And that this is the message that I want people to remember from 2020. I am now, at this moment, all that I need to be.
All right. All right, testing audio, testing lighting. Okay. Hello, friends. I hope you are having a super happy day so far. It's just another day at home, another day to be indecisive about what to wear. I sound really shallow. I mean, I look like I'm put together on the top, but check out these bad boys. Huh. Oh, that's great. There's a stain. Love that. I hate these pants. Why did I even write that into the script? I literally could have just not. But what if I told you that there's a way to shake things up a bit? Today I'm going to be doing something I'd like to call quarantine couture. That is such a gross title. To kick things off, I am so excited to be sharing a brand new product with you. No, I'm not. Oh. All right, just do what they want you to do, and we can be done with this. This video is sponsored by Squeaky Clean, the newest line of disinfectant sprays that is versatile enough to be used on any surface, including the human skin. Just because something can be used on the human skin does not mean it should be, and I have the burn to prove it. But you know, listen to me. I've been using Squeaky Clean's products to clean off the packages that contain some of the accessories that I'll be featuring later on in this video. The product helps keep these packages clean from the germs found on other humans' hands. I sound like I'm four. I am a preschooler telling boys to stay away because they have cooties. But before I get into showing you how to accessorize your sweatpants, because let's be honest, that's irrelevant, let's clean off some of these packages that just arrived with some of Squeaky Clean's products, because that's what our world has come to. Time-lapse. Cool. That box is done. Purchase your own Squeaky Clean products so you don't have to worry about bacteria on your boxes. The irony? You probably won't be able to find it. Huh. I'm
advertising a product that people can't even purchase. It's practically non-existent on store shelves. And beyond that, it does absolutely nothing. It's all false advertising. Oh, and now I'm contributing to the false advertising. People need something that does something. I'm such a fake. I'm sitting inside while the world outside is crumbling. I'm making money off of people's fears and their sicknesses. My viewers give me such a big space and I fill it with absolute garbage. I waste people's time and money. Oh my god, and money. I want to scream at someone. I want to scream, do not listen to me. But even if I did, you'll just find someone else to fill that space.
What I want people in the future to remember about this pandemic is that we have to stay happy and keep being positive in these times.
The call to defund the police, widely discussed in the U.S.
We interrupt our program to bring you this.
For centuries, our government has hidden very important information from us. Main events that happened only 50 years ago seem like distant memories. They've corrupted our brains and made us look like incompetent fools. This happens no longer. The buck stops here. We cannot afford to have history repeat itself yet again. This is the time for action. Stop spreading these lies. We have to defy.
400 years, we're still not free. Promise us life, but no guarantee. There's no room to disagree. No end in sight, this is why we fight. We've had enough work gaining traction. This is a vow, a call to action. Now's the time to unify. No end in sight, this is why we fight. We can't let history repeat again. It's time for social disruption.
And this is not the only battle in our midst. Women in the LGBTQ community deserve their truths to be heard.
They want their way.
did he find this time capsule?
Where did it come from?
Have you been hiding this from us?
To be quite honest, I wasn't even sure I was going to show it all to you. Unlike generations before, I decided to do what's right and show the real history of 2020. Not what the media has been spreading to you for so long. This is the cold, hard truth. That year wasn't all fun and games. It was tragedy after tragedy, and real change occurred. But we need to move on and leave the past behind us into a new future, a better one. If no one else has any concerns, this will conclude our—
Wait, is that all that was left in the time capsule?
Don't interrupt. This is important.
I think this letter is more important. Was there anything missing, a page or a ripped letter?
Actually, we did find a diary, but we didn't think anything of it. All the pages were ruined except for one, but half of the message was missing.
I've got the other half right here. What does it say?
To my dear daughter, this message is for you. Be brave and make mistakes with your own path to choose.
Grammy, this letter wasn't to great-grandpa. It was actually to you, from your mom.
I don't understand. I've had this letter my whole life, and I never knew.
Let's read them together.
Find our way just like we always do. Love.